Power is back on in Algiers after thousands of customers woke up in the dark this morning. Street and traffic lights were out for several hours at the peak of morning traffic, leading to at least two crashes. WDSU's Casey Ferran tells us what Entergy says caused the outage and how it impacted the morning commute.
At the peak of this outage, just shy of 5,000 customers were reportedly without power. It proved to be a bit of an irritating drive for commuters this morning.
The power outage was first reported by Entergy shortly before 5 this morning. There was no electricity along about a 3-mile stretch of General Meyer Avenue in Algiers. Street and traffic lights were out there and on Cable and Holiday. One resident said he was reluctant to leave home until daylight.
On General Meyer or Holiday, when there's no policemen out here, you have guys running these cars 50, 60 miles an hour, and they figure that they have the right of way. So the best thing you can do is wait till they get to daybreak around 7 o'clock and then move out.
At least two accidents were reported to New Orleans police due to traffic light outages. This one at Holiday and General De Gaulle happened just before 6 a.m. An elderly woman was taken to the hospital with neck and back pain, according to her son.
Called me at 5 minutes to 6 saying she'd been in a real bad accident, and my wife drove here and then I drove here, and she was sitting in the car and she couldn't move. She was saying her head hurt and her back was hurt.
Tommy Guidry says his 81-year-old mother, Doris Jones, was headed to her job at Bromart, where she's a cashier. Instead, she was carried away in an ambulance. The second driver said he didn't have any serious injuries. The second wreck happened a block away on MacArthur and Holiday. Both drivers received medical attention on the scene. Entergy New Orleans said a broken cable inside a substation caused the outage.
Entergy had crews on the scene within an hour of the outage being reported, and right now, power has been completely restored to this area. On your side, I'm Casey Ferran, WDSU News.